Hi there. My name is Mary Frida Kiera. Today I want to talk to you about the nice and lovely car activator.
What's going on?
Now, I'm not starting a vlog on hair products, for those of you who may be wondering. I just want to take a focus on this specific product. Among the many other products in the market, this is one of the car activators that is branded nice and lovely. It would be foolish to go to the supermarket looking for a hair food and buy this car activator, because this product has a particular purpose for which it is made. The nice and lovely hair food can not look down on this car activator, because it cannot do the same thing that the hair food can. And why is this? This is because the car activator was made for a specific purpose and the hair food was made for a specific purpose. Why is it then that we try to force each other to be what we think the other should be? Don't you think it is out of wisdom that God told us not to judge each other?
Yeah.
And why is it that we heavily depend on other people's opinions of us to determine our self-esteem, our self-worth? Why is it that we want to get the value of ourselves from whatever the media is streaming and what the standards have set as what is acceptable beauty or complexion or body weight and size? Why is it that we are so bent to be uniform when it is clear that God meant us to be the unique people that He created us to be? Don't you think it is too much to expect a fellow human being, a product like yourself, to give you your value of self, whether this be your spouse or your child or your boyfriend or girlfriend? Don't you think it is too heavy of a load for you to expect them to validate you? Don't you also think it is a heavy load for you to expect yourself to know what you are meant to do? If you buy a product today, for example a fridge, you will go through the manual to see what the manufacturer meant that product to do. And yet we try to live our lives as if we just popped out of nowhere, as if we have our own answers to what we are meant to do. Self-awareness is a journey that is as important as anything else. And in an era where so many people are suffering from mental health issues, self-awareness is the biggest root of our instability in our minds. We are not self-aware enough to say no in circumstances that threaten to take away our dignity. We are not self-aware enough to push for our dreams, to fight for what we believe in. So we go along the way of saying yes so that people will love us and accept us as we are. But we never get there, because we face rejection from all ends, doing all things. And I'm not saying that when you're self-aware, you will never face rejection, no. But you will be able to forge forward. And so where do we get our self-awareness? And I would ask, where else except from the one that made us, the one that knows us, the one that sat down and thought that a girl would be born into this world and she would be called Mary Frida. And there's a specific purpose for which I have placed her on this earth. Why not go back to our Creator by reading His word and trying to figure out what it is He made us for? I have found that the days I am most fulfilled are the days that I am so sure that whatever I put my hands and thoughts into is what God brought me here to do. There's no one in this world who can fill the void that you have in your life that is brought forth by not knowing who you are. You may be trying to fit in with all the wrong crowds, and maybe they're even doing noble things, but you're trying to force yourself to be something that you are not meant to do because maybe of your circumstances or because you've been made to believe that. But self-awareness is a journey that you need to take alone, you and God. By developing a relationship with your Maker, then you're able to look within yourself and filter through His Word to find out, why is it that God made me this way particularly? Why did He craft me like this? Why did He place the emotions that I'm feeling in me? Why is it that I struggle so much with this thing? And why is it that I do this with ease? And God is a perfect Maker. He knows how to minister to you. He knows how to deal with you with love and with affection and with mercy.
Wow.
And with God, you have the grace to ride on that you will never be condemned. And by knowing that you are truly and unconditionally loved, then you're not only able to love yourself and accept yourself as you are, but you're able to extend that love to others, and you're able to discern when the circumstance requires that you say no. So, for us to maintain our mental health, our physical health, to live a fulfilled life, just like for this product to do what it was meant to do, we have to know who we are. There is just no shortcut.